Okay, I am at High Banks off the Dripping Rock Trail down over in the ravine. If you go to the Nature Center and you get onto the Dripping Rock Trail, head to the right or to the left, and it might be like the second path off to your right, just an old path. Well, it's, I mean, it's used, but just heading down a hill. Just come off the main trail, off the Dripping Rock Trail, come down in the bottom, down this little stream down here. It's some really cool things. Now, I can't remember the name of it, but I'll look it up and I'll put it on this video. But they are interesting, round-shaped rocks in the riverbed. Let's see if I can come over here and get a better view. Here's one here. We'll talk about that one there in a minute. You see them? They're really cool. There's a larger one. Now, talking to one of the naturalists, what he said these things are is years ago, when there was a sea here, there was creatures that would die, and then silt would basically layer over top of them and encase them in these rocks. Well, if you were to break one apart, he says, they either could be hollow or they could be actually organic material on the inside. Now, I'm not sure what the whole process of how these are formed, but then you got one here, because I asked him about something that got a little hole in the top, like this one here, and he says what they do when they become, you know, over the years, you know, the soil wears back off from the top of them, and they become exposed to the air, and they start to break down. Now, he was telling me that when they built 270, they found some of these as large as a vehicle. And that's really interesting. He believes that the size of them could depend on the type of animal that was inside of them. You know, I don't know a lot about them. I'm just going with what he told me. But they are really cool. Like I say, they're in this little stream bed down here. Here's a small one. I mean, you can't move them. They're part of the, yeah, they're encased in the rock. This one here, I'm assuming, is an old one. Some old ones that have really deteriorated. I mean, the tops are completely gone off of those. There's one there. I don't know if there's any more over here or not. No, I don't see any. But they're really interesting. Like I said, you gotta come off the Dripping Rock Trail, head out of the Nature Center, head left, turn left, and the trail is just right up there. Top of the hill. Come down the side path, you can see it there coming down. And they're right here in this little stream. Like I said, I'll look the name up and I'll put it on this video before I post it. That one there looks like it sort of got another rock encased inside that one.